Channel 2 Action News investigates matted fur, filthy kennels, and puppies sick and underweight, but up for adoption. Volunteers at one local animal shelter say pictures like these are the norm. We started investigating the facility in Hall County after tips started to pour into our newsroom about what some call a shelter astray.
Channel 2 anchor Justin Wilfon with us and took those concerns to the county.
Justin, those concerns center around what they call a lack of care and an absence of leadership they say is harming the animals.
I've seen animals on the floor with fleas on them, feces in the cages, no water, mats, like sticks in their fur.
For Katie Grant and six other Hall County Animal Shelter volunteers, this was their cry for help, sitting down with us to tell us about their desperate fight to help the animals.
They don't get out unless volunteers take them out, and oftentimes they're, stepping in their own poop and, it's a mess in there.
Dean Saleo has been a volunteer for 5 years and runs new volunteer orientations.
Dealing with, bowls that are not clean, cages that are not cleaned properly, dogs with poop stuck to their fur.
Sonia Ender's rescue, Perfect Pets, pulls from multiple shelters, including Hall County.
Hall County, it's different because it's over the years become a fight, like an uphill battle.
She showed us Hall County documents from 2014 for this dog, Elmo, showing us he was in the shelter for 7 weeks with a broken leg. By the time she was able to take him, the leg had to be amputated. She told us things haven't gotten better.
It's been harder to get the dogs out that really need us most as a rescue.
The volunteers tell us it all stems from poor leadership by this man, shelter director Mike Ledford.
It's obvious that, to me that he doesn't care about what goes on at the shelter.
Maybe once or twice we have seen him there.
The county defended Ledford's management, but over the summer it did make a change, bringing in the warden of the Hall County Jail to oversee Ledford. But so far, volunteers say he's not made a difference. We obtained this audio recording of the warden, Walt Davis, in his first meeting with volunteers.
I started dealing with the animal shelter July 1. Okay? I don't really care about what happened before then. Why is that? I'm not responsible. But I am now.
But 3 months after he took over, volunteers sent us these images showing puppies that appear to be neglected, unable to reach the water in their cage, and infested with fleas on the adoption room floor. The warden told us there was no neglect, and in this email agreed to sit down with us to talk about what he called positive changes at the shelter. But when we pointed out discrepancies in what he called facts, he sent us to the county's public information officer. In an email, she told us proper procedure and protocol were followed in this case. Shelter staff is constantly reviewing those procedures to ensure the highest level of care is provided to all animals that are in their care.
They just need to follow through with statements they've made in the past to the volunteer group about caring about the animals.
This group of volunteers still longs for the day they don't need to take any more pictures like this.
You kind of see something that gives you a little bit of hope, and then, in less than a month, it's right back to, just not caring again.
Justin Wilfon here with us. You got new information today about this investigation.
Yeah, just this morning, the Department of Agriculture sent us this report here of an inspection done after a consumer complaint about those puppies we just showed you. In it, Mike Ledford says the puppies were aged incorrectly at intake and his staff did not observe any flea infestation. The inspector also says all animals there have access to fresh food and water. Still, though, those volunteers would like to see some big improvements at that shelter.
Looks like something needs to be done there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Justin, thank you.
Some-